I'm so sweet that I'm bad for your teeth.
I just threw up a little in my mouth. Weird.
No, that's all the same. But guess who got 20/20 vision? Just kidding, I don't have 20/20 vision. I have 20/15 vision, according to my appointment yesterday. Guess who has better than perfect vision? This girl!
Good morning, good evening, good afternoon. Welcome back to Lilly Singh Vlogs, where we hustle harder, productivity lives here. Little Spider-Man intro, but if a spider ever bit me, I would be jumping off a cliff, so that did not happen. It is about 2 p.m., I had a little bit of a sleep in, had a big old breakfast, took a big old poop. Ryan Higa, is that you? We're gonna have a very productive Sunday. Here's the mission for today. First, get in focus with me, camera. Focus on me. Go through my inbox, write some music, come up with some video ideas, go to Hasan Minhaj's show, and maybe do my laundry. We'll see all that and more. Let's do it. 2 headbutts already? Kill the game. And a hair toss? Oh my god.
Also, yesterday, after a year, I washed my makeup brushes, these two, so I should look like Tyra Banks any second. Hey yo, mukbang later? Mukbang? Do you know what that is? A mukbang? A mukbang? I don't know. We're doing that later.
I'm just feeling like I'm in a productive mood today. I'm gonna do so many things. I can already feel it. Are you with me? First things first, yo, look at that. I'm gonna get rid of this right here. How we just getting started? So I shot a video the other day, and as a result, I had a whole bunch of school stuff at my house. Some desks, some chairs, the works. And I was like, yo, I miss sitting at Scarbro. You poop on the floor? To be fair, the thing is closed, so that's my bad. But you gotta learn how to go through the door. There was some school stuff, and I was like, I miss sitting at a school desk so much. So I was like, yo, I want a school desk. So then I got a school desk, and now I'm gonna put it here. Actually, what happened is I gotta return the stuff on Monday, and I didn't return this yet. I'm gonna make a little office on the patio, school style. You ready for this? Let's do it. Back to school for real. Ooh!
Scarbro's also here in his little teepee. You getting work done, buddy? Good boy.
I'm really feeling these vibes right here. I feel like I'm gonna buy a school desk and put on every floor. Just having a mini desk on every floor, so wherever I wanna work, like maybe today it's the patio, maybe tomorrow it's the hallway. I can just work wherever I want. I'm kind of excited. Guess who just cleared her inbox? I'll give you a hint. It me! So a lot of my video ideas are musical, and one of them is a little controversial, but I think it should be fine because I'm also like talking about myself. I'm talking about the world. And so we gonna see. Speaking of music, I am mother effing shook at Nicki's album. It is so good. Oh my god. Specifically this one song. Hold on. This right here. Oh my god, listen to this.
Hold on, the gang shit.
Caribbean dance hall vibes. She even shouts out Marshall in the outro. It's just, it's so good it hurts. I'm in physical pain. I'm in physical pain, bro. I think I pulled my leg.
Alright, so we're gonna go to Umami Burger and order all the food. What do you think?
I am excited about this endeavor.
That's the most emotion you'll get out of Humble.
Mukbang, don't know how to say it, never, he hasn't even heard of this before.
Never heard of this before.
We got a bunch of food that is, I believe we can eat all of it, because I didn't want to waste a bunch of food, that's not what I wanted to do. So, that's what's happening, we're going to eat, I asked some questions on my Instagram, and we just talk.
Pretty much. Just eat and chat.
We just eat and chat. Scarbro, you can't have any food, okay, baby? Hold on, we got impossible sliders, and I just realized I didn't say no tomato on them. The devil. Of course we're going to cheers. Hurrah! We have all this food. If it was your last meal on earth, what would you eat?
Oh, really good. Oh god, so good.
Delicious. Is that the first question? My last meal would be my mom's roti and brown dal.
You have that like every day.
And that's why when I'm dying, I want to feel like I'm home in my mother's love.
Said I was born a mama's boy, I'm gonna die a mama's boy.
I'm a proud mama's boy.
See, I always debate between this if I would eat meat for my last meal, because I'm a vegetarian. But I'm like, do I want to try meat one more time? I don't think I would. If I would, my mom's chicken curry. If not though, because I'd probably get sick and die from that before the freaking gunshot. I think it would be.
Why is it a gunshot? What if it was an animal attacking you? Would you try to eat the animal to protect yourself?
It's very rude to interrupt people when they're answering questions. Kraft dinner macaroni and cheese, 99 cent Kraft dinner. That's what I would have. Truly, I love it so much. Those that I don't know, by the way, Humble used to be a teacher. Did you guys know that? Humble used to teach living children.
Yeah, so I used to teach grade 3, taught grade 4, mm-hmm. taught grade 5.
What kind of teacher were you?
Very funny, but very strict. My rules in my classroom were so strict. Teachers actually.
You took all the napkins? Yeah. Carry on.
Very rude to interrupt people during stories. Don't be mansplaining me. So yeah, I just had very strict rules in my classroom. And the rules weren't designed for like discipline. They were designed for me not to be bothered. So I... And it got to the point where I had other teachers telling me like, why are you so strict on these kids? I wasn't mean.
Example of a rule, go.
If you do not do your homework... So if you do not get your planner signed, that's an instant... we call it quiet meditation, but that was a nice word for detention. So you had to sit on the carpet instead of going to recess and you would quietly meditate.
Oh, not bad. But that was like, if you don't get your agenda signed, you have to comb my beard.
And then the kids have to always line up in the exact same line every single time in alphabetical order.
Why? Because he's that teacher. Oh my God, he's that teacher.
Because that way kids wouldn't be talking to each other because the chances of them being in alphabetical order and being near their friends aren't very likely. It helped me during fire drills. Again, it was designed for my peace of mind. And that's what it was. And that's why I'm not a teacher
anymore. So if you're a parent, know your child is going to school with wonderful teachers like this one.
No, that's why I'm no longer a teacher. Other teachers, you guys are dope. And I couldn't cut it. And that's why I'm not there anymore.
I have a question. In our past relationships, you tell them what kind of girlfriend you think I am with people I've dated, and I tell them what kind of boyfriend I think you are with people you've dated. I don't think we have two, like, this is not something Humble and I talk about very often. We don't often talk about relationships. You just talk about work and all that stuff. So, like, this is a new area. What kind of girlfriend do you think I am?
I think...
Be careful now.
Okay. I think you were very...
And be honest, don't protect my feelings.
1000%. Don't worry about that. Nobody's worried about protecting your feelings here. The people need to know, okay? I think in many elements of your relationship, you were probably extremely attentive.
I got some vodka.
Put in a lot of effort. You didn't really phone a lot of things in certain elements of your relationship.
Effort.
I think, but also at the same time, if anything was getting in the way of your own personal peace or happiness, I'm sure you probably didn't react to that well.
This sounds like a lot of sugarcoating. Just say what you want to say.
And I also think that you were probably, you know they say ignorance is bliss? Sometimes I think you're so smart that you might be allergic to all the sweetness that a boy can provide for you because you can see through it. But that's the best we got. So you probably rolled your eyes a lot in your relationship.
That was a lot tamer than I thought it was going to be.
What do you think I was going to say?
If I had to describe myself as a girlfriend, it'd be, I really like doing a good job at things. So if I don't feel like I can do a good job, I'm very honest about that. And sometimes that takes the romanticness away from things.
Give an example.
I've broken up with people and I've honestly said, this doesn't function. We don't function. Like, I can't romanticize that experience. It's like, this doesn't work. I'm not good at this. I realistically cannot be good at this. Like, I'm just very straightforward. And so I don't sugarcoat things.
Have you ever been broken up with?
Not in a proper way. No. I've never had someone sit me down and break up with me. I've always had like sketchy people do sketchy things to end a relationship.
But have you had somebody decide that they want to end a relationship that you still wanted?
Yes.
You still wanted
it
to happen.
Yes. And then the next day I got drunk and texted them. What kind of boyfriend do you think you are? I think you and I are very similar in a way. Sometimes it can be very robotic. We don't always take emotions into consideration because I feel like we have selective emotions. I think you have selective emotions. So I think...
All my emotions are reserved for dogs. Legitimately. That scene in Fresh Prince.
I ain't need him then and I don't need him now.
Will.
Now, you know what, Uncle Phil? I'm gonna get through college without him. I'm gonna get a great job without him. I'm gonna marry me a beautiful honey. And I'm having me a whole bunch of kids. I'm gonna be a better father than he ever was. And I sure as hell don't need him for that. Cause ain't a damn thing he could ever teach me about how to love my kids. How come he don't want me, man?
You care about people, you're a good boyfriend, but I think sometimes you can't understand all the emotions associated with certain situations and you're very like black and white about things, but not everything is black and white. But I think ultimately you do care and you do try. And I think he does sweet things. I've seen him do sweet things for people. He fronts like a mother effer.
I am a sweet guy. I'm not fronting.
Listen, look around where you went.
Everybody knows that the only constants here is that I'm so sweet that I'm bad for your teeth.
I just threw up a little in my mouth. We will disagree on this. I think humble fronts. Humble is very sweet, but if you talk about it, he's like, no, man, I don't do nothing sweet. I don't do nothing. You do sweet things.
I'm the sweetest guy ever. I am the definition of nice guys finish first.
He just hasn't finished first yet. How do you feel about butts?
I think anybody who enjoys big butts has integrity and does not lie.
I second that motion.
I am an appreciator of butts.
I also like butts. One of my girls accept, I check out guys' butts. I like butts. I check out girls' butts too. I like a good butt regardless.
Can I tell you a secret?
Yeah, tell the world a secret. Go.
If you ever do want to enjoy a butt, the first thing you should do is look at their shoes. Because if they're wearing high heels, they're cheating.
Wow. Dumbest lie you ever told people that they believed.
I was driving in a car, with all my friends were in the car, and we were hanging out with these other girls, and they were a car full of girls. And we were trying to lose them in this park. And what ended up happening was they had ended up hitting my car, like, head on, but like this hard. That's it.
Well, we got an instant replay of that collision that just happened.
It was a very light collision, no damage, nothing. It was literally a little bump. And what we did was we took off immediately, and then we told them that one of the guys in the car got injured, and then we had to take them to the hospital. And they believed
it. Bad person.
It was so bad. They believed it, and then we sent them to the hospital, and we just made up a floor that the hospital didn't even have. They're all calling and trying to figure out what's going on.
You're horrible.
Meanwhile, we're at like Tim Hortons laughing so much. However, when they figured out that we lied, they shaving creamed my entire car and then wrapped it in toilet paper on the spot. In a parking lot of a coffee shop where I had no hose or nothing to clean my car off with. So they got their revenge immediately.
Biggest lie I've told people that they believe is that I'm funny. Truly. I'm not funny, but I've convinced people that I am.
I can confirm she's not funny.
Moving on, moving right along. If you wanted to push my buttons, what would someone have to do to push my buttons?
Tell you to make them a sandwich.
If I had to push Humble's buttons, there's a variety of things I could do.
Really?
There's two things that piss Humble off in such an irrational way, okay? What? He's so hangry. I know you say you've addressed that. The biggest fight Humble and I've ever had, at the end of the fight, he literally said this sentence to me. He's like, I don't know, man. Honestly, after I ate, I was like, okay. I swear to God.
When you eat, it gives you perspective.
No, I cried. It was right there. I was crying because I was so upset. And I told him, like, is this just because you're hungry? He maintained for an hour. I cried. At the very end, he was like, maybe I was just hungry. I swear to God. Okay. Second thing you want to do to piss off Humble? It's such a specific thing. Make Humble wait in a line.
I hate waiting in line.
For something he doesn't care about.
Which is pretty much everything. Everything that requires a line. I don't want to be there. I don't ever want to wait in line.
The most angry I've ever seen Humble. We're at like a fancy event and there's a meet and greet and Humble does not care to meet this person at all, okay? But security would be like, excuse me, please get in the line. Humble turns into a different person. Well, I don't even want to be here in this line. I don't care about this line. It's so irrational.
Yes, that is, I hate it. Why do people stand in line for places they don't even want to be? There should be a separate line for people who don't want to be there. And we could just sit in the corner and be hangry. But that would be an express line. And it'd be like, yo, we know you don't want to be here. So we're gonna save you the headache of having to wait in line with the rest of these line standing suckers. And we're gonna address this.
If you had to sculpt someone that would be a good match for me today, what would that person be? How would you sculpt them?
Well, he'd obviously be a pretty boy.
I'm just saying this because I date a lot of pretty boys.
What else?
And have they ever worked out?
Is that not?
Have they ever worked out?
You require like a pretty boy thug. But he can't just be a pretty boy thug. He also has to be a pretty boy thug who's got his stuff going on. But he has to come from an environment where he was a little bit rougher around the edges. You would appreciate that. You would respond well to that. Marshawn Lynch.
Trey Songz.
That's a pretty boy thug?
Mm-hmm.
I think he's more thug.
Who are the people I would date? I would 100% date Selena Gomez.
Is this based off looks or personality?
Both. Emma Watson. I'd date Obama.
Really?
When he was younger, yeah.
He's a smooth talker.
I'd date Michelle Obama. I think that concludes my list.
That's your list?
Wait. No, Lauren knows this. Fifth Harmony Lauren. She knows. I date her.
I think you need someone with a little bit more spice. I think that list plus some more spice. Like, if there was like a meter of like sweet to spicy, I think you need it dead in the center.
You must not have seen Selena Gomez in I Just Wanna Look Good
For You. Oh, is she spicy?
That concludes our mukbang, whatever bang. We have a lot of food still finished. Have not tried one of these, have you?
I did.
And your thoughts?
It is a lot of potato.
I'm not mad at it.
You're not mad at it?
I'm not mad. Why does the internet like things like this?
It's like a window into our lives.
There you go. And you know what's gonna happen? I'm gonna stop recording and I'm gonna take off the mask. And really, I'm gonna be humble and he's the Bye!
Boom, 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 pack.
OOTD accessory. Simple things, simple things, simple things.
Listen.com, listen.com, listen.com. Let go.
All right, so we're at Hasan's show, but there's no photography, no phones, no nothing. So I gotta say bye to you. Bye.
Yo!
Shout out Hasan Minhaj, bro. His show is so good from beginning to end. Humble cried.
I cried.
Tears of laughter. He cried.
So many tears of laughter.
He punched me in my leg during some jokes. He's like punching me. I'm like, why am I getting physically abused? Because
they're that funny, man. And Hasan Minhaj is that funny.
He's super dope and he's so nice. We've been internet friends for a while, but it's the first time we ever met. So sweet. He's like a mutual fan. He knows all about my vlogs. He's like, you're hosting the vlogs and everything. I just had a great, great time. We couldn't show you, but that's good. You should watch it on your own.
Let's also talk about that. So they put everybody's phones.
Hold on. We're going to talk about it. I need to put this up prop. We're going to talk about this right now. Hold on. Tell them what they did.
Put everybody's phones in these pouches and they close them. So this is a big thing in comedy. Because comedy guys write their acts once. You can't record it and then put it out in the world.
So your phone's locked in a pouch and you can't open it inside the venue, okay? Now, obviously, Hasan Minhaj's show, there's a bunch of brown people. So I knew, I'm like, I'm running to some fans. I just need to tell you, let me preface this by saying I don't mind taking pictures with fans. But something I noticed was the interactions I had with people when their phones were locked in a pouch were night and day compared to other interactions I have. Usually I meet someone within the first 5 seconds like, and can't take a picture. I had like conversations with people. We bought drinks with people. We did cheers with people.
There was nothing else they could have except the conversation. Yeah. And it was much more pleasant.
It was just awesome. I like actually got to engage and talk to some of my fans and they couldn't take pictures and it was like, it was just, it was just a pleasant experience.
It was a refreshing, pleasant experience. Mm-hmm. And I think all those people got a wonderful memory. They just can't prove it to anybody and get a couple likes on Instagram.
You know what that means? It never happened. Yeah. Yo, when you're watching this right now, a main channel video is gonna be up. Make sure you check that out. Make sure you say what's up, Drake Super 60s. But right now, today, I'm gonna end this. I gotta wake up at 5 a.m. for a shoot tomorrow. So let's see how we did. Until tomorrow, lots of hotter Super Monday. Woo!